Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. Let's discuss two types of assays that are used to understand ADME properties, solubility and permeability assays. By the end of this video, students will be able to describe solubility assays, outline the design of membrane permeability assays, list the common permeability assay formats, and define efflux ratio. Solubility is a vital property for essentially all drugs. Oral drugs must dissolve in the GI tract to be absorbed. Injected drugs are administered as a solution. Fortunately, solubility assays are quick and easy to perform. Solubility assays involve mixing a compound in an aqueous buffer and measuring how much dissolves. There are many options for solubility assays: pH, inclusion of additives to simulate gastric or intestinal fluid, and measuring the rate of dissolving, dissolution. Many drug discovery programs set solubility goals, perhaps greater than 60 micrograms per milliliter, but the required solubility depends on the drug dose. A low-dose drug can have a lower solubility. Permeability refers to membrane permeability, the ability of a compound to cross biological membranes. Oral drugs must cross membranes in the lining of the GI tract. Drugs that affect a target inside a cell must also cross membranes. Permeability assays monitor how quickly a molecule crosses a cell monolayer. The layer has two faces, the apical face and basolateral face. Compound flow can be measured from A to B or B to A. Three common assay formats differ based on the origin of the membranes: Caco 2 cells, a colon cancer cell line; MDCK, Madin-Darby canine kidney cells; and PAMPA, parallel artificial membrane permeability assay. Membrane permeability is a property that is normally reported as PAP, apparent permeability, in units of 10 to the minus 6 centimeters per second. There are no fixed values for good or bad permeability, but often apparent permeability for a drug is at least 10 times 10 to the minus 6th centimeters per second. A lower permeability can prevent adequate absorption to achieve efficacious exposure of a drug. With membrane permeability results, researchers often report the efflux ratio of a molecule. The efflux ratio is the ratio of B to A permeability to A to B permeability. It might be surprising that the permeability can differ based on the direction of transit, but it can. Differences normally arise from transporters, like the ones in red in the diagram, found on the apical face of the cell monolayer. These are efflux transporters that pump a molecule out of a cell to the apical side of the cell layer. The action of these efflux transporters increases B to A permeability and reduces A to B permeability. And if efflux transporters are active, then the efflux ratio will be greater than 1. If a compound has an undesirably high ER, then structural changes may be required so that the molecule is a less favorable substrate for the transporter, thereby reducing the efflux ratio closer to a value of 1. Not all permeability assays detect efflux. PAMPA membranes do not contain transporter proteins. MDCK has some transporters, and Caco2-based assays have the highest presence of transporters. So along with solubility assays, permeability assays and understanding the related efflux ratio can help researchers understand whether a molecule in an early phase of discovery will likely show good oral absorption once it advances into in vivo studies for PK, efficacy, and safety. We have described both solubility and permeability assays. We have also defined the efflux ratio, which can be measured if the appropriate permeability assay format is used. I hope you have a better understanding of how solubility and permeability assays help predict the ADME properties of a compound. Please like, subscribe to the channel, or leave a comment. Take care.